We are following developing news out of Washington tonight. The Mueller report is finished and has been turned over to the Justice Department. Joining us now is Attorney Mark Reichel, criminal defense lawyer here in Sacramento, and you have extensive experience at the federal level. Thanks for being here. We appreciate it.
My pleasure.
Okay, so you're going to help us break this down a bit. What stands out to you right now?
This is still within the executive branch, okay, because the special counsel law is actually within the executive branch. It's when the Department of Justice feels there's a conflict, they want to do an investigation of anything. And here early on, 2 years ago, they felt there was a conflict, created the special counsel. He has already issued some indictments about Russian interference. In fact, there's several indictments that are pending specifically on that. But as far as tying it to the Trump campaign, which is, as we all know, is what everyone's waiting for, mm-hmm, that's what's in this report. It is allowed by law for the Justice Department to take it themselves to look at it, to redact anything that's executive privilege. And then they do have to brief Congress, but there's no real answer yet from the courts whether they have to turn the entire report over. In the Clinton scandal with Lewinsky and so forth, the entire report was made public.
Yeah, very different. I was comparing this to Ken Starr's report,
right,
and that was public right away. Mueller, really, through this whole process, it has been tight-lipped, no leaks, no one knows what's going on.
Washington is a sieve where everything comes out and there's leaks. There has been absolutely no leaks whatsoever. This is in control of a very typical federal prosecutor. They're very restrained, they're very conservative, they follow the law very closely. The Department of Justice has a strong position that a sitting president cannot be indicted. So in that report, there may be that phrase, and then say, these are the facts why the person should be indicted for collusion or obstruction. And the big fight is going to be Congress saying we're a separate branch. By the Constitution, we have oversight. We demand to see that report. And the executive branch, a separate branch, is going to say, hey, we have our own rules internally. This is our own report. We put this together. And they'll determine what they want to release. And it could be the funny or strange position where the Democrats in Congress are saying Mueller didn't do a good enough job. And the Republicans in Congress and the Senate and the Trump presidency saying Mueller did a great job and worked really hard. Mm-hmm. That may come out to play in front of us.
Well, the White House is saying, there are some quotes tonight saying that, hey, we won. The president is at Mar-a-Lago tonight, reportedly surrounded by attorneys there. And his new attorney general, William Barr, is saying that there's speculation that there could be some reports or something released this weekend. How likely do you think that's going to happen?
My understanding is, yeah, that because of the public outcry, I mean, we paid a lot of money for this. Mm-hmm. It's something that has captivated the attention of the entire world. So I understand the Attorney General's decision and desire to get some of this to Congress. You'll notice there are congresspersons right now demanding immediately for the entire report immediately now. At some point, they're going to subpoena it. At some point, the Justice Department may say no, and we may have Bush versus Gore all over again that we had in 2000
Court, right?
Before the U.S. Supreme Court. And they'll make the answer on whether Congress has the power to get that report. That's something that was made by the Justice Department in the executive branch.
Can Congress subpoena Mueller?
Yes, they can. They can subpoena anyone under the Constitution. Mm-hmm. They can subpoena anyone under the Constitution to do an investigation. The question is will the Justice Department then come in and assert executive privilege? Executive privilege in the Nixon case 40, 50 years ago now, it was held to apply only for national security. So if they want to invoke it, they're going to have to hide behind that, use national security as a shield to prevent him from testifying.
So this process is far from over. We're just getting started.
It's in the federal system.
Okay.
The federal system, as I tell people all the time, is one step back from the powdered wigs. It's very reserved, it's very slow moving, and it's very conservative. And it only comes in and gets an exact indictment. It doesn't go after all sorts of things. It's very limited in its jurisdiction.
Mark Reichel, we always appreciate your expertise. Thanks for being here tonight.
My pleasure.